Love it or hate it, but data is here to stay. Every action we make, every movement we make generates data points. And why is that, you might ask? Well, there's multiple reasons, but for me, the most important one is we all crave to make the right decisions. The future is uncertain, and it's packed with fears. And it can be so much comforting if we're able to make decisions with some assurance over the outcome. And that's where data can and should help us. Look at today. It's COVID-19. We can't see the virus, but data is helping us to decide on when we open up, when we close down, when we move to digital events. And we're doing that on a global level, on a local level, but maybe more importantly, also on a very personal level. We went from incidence numbers on continents to countries to incidence in small areas to crowd control to contact tracing on a personal level. And all that data helped us make decisions that were educated, that helped us move forward. And today, generating data is very easy. The costs have gone very low due to IoT. But what we mustn't forget, and what is really important if we look at client-facing analytics, that is that we need to make that data human and impactful. For example, take millions of records on temperature data. By themselves, they don't mean anything. But once we start segmenting across regions, we plot them day by day, we look at evolutions over the years, we start seeing the effects of climate change. And we can dig deeper and we can start seeing what affected climate change, what are some things we need to take into account with, and what are some decisions that would move the needle. And I think today we're all working in companies or in organizations that generate heaps amounts of data. But are you already giving something back to your end users? Are you taking away some of their fears, some of their uncertainties? Are you, in return, giving them valuable insights on which they can drive decision-making, on which they can act? Because if you already do, you already know this, but client-facing analytics, and especially actionable client-facing analytics, is a growth driver for your company. Your users tend to be more loyal. They stick with your software. And so it's really something that you should be doing today. There's literally nothing stopping you today from going to client-facing analytics because it helps growing your business. So what is a good start if you're looking at client-facing analytics? First thing I would say is dashboards, especially in versatile environments where you have multiple factors influencing decisions. So what do you need to look at in dashboards in a customer-facing context? Well, first thing that is really important is timing. You want them to make decisions on top of that data. And so timing is important because there can be opportunity costs of doing them sooner or later. And especially in IoT, where everything is real time, it can make sense to do it very timely. And so whenever data is going over threshold, give them the opportunity to act on top of that. Furthermore, adapt your message to your end user. Adapt it to their role, to their expertise level, so that they engage with that data, so that they're driven to finding these insights and sometimes uncovering even insights you haven't thought of yet. And that way, they help you grow, identify, and solve better and harder solutions for your customers. And that becomes so much more powerful if you personalize it to their specific context. Because you don't want to bombard them with data. No, you just want to show them the insights that matter to that specific person at that moment in time, given their specific context. Of course, there's a lot more you need to take into account. Some of the things are security. Everybody is rightfully concerned about data privacy. You don't want to have customer A see data from customer B, so make sure you are very aware and looking a lot at that at security. Performance, of course, is very important. Nobody wants to wait for getting insights. And scalability, I would say, is very important as well. not only scaling in numbers, but also scaling in the type of users that you address. Because if you operate globally, you want to have dashboards that are able to cope with multilingualism, with multiple devices, but also if you're operating globally with multiple time zones. Noon in Mechelen isn't the same thing as noon in New York or in Los Angeles. So you need to be able to cope with that. But dashboards should be more than just visual representations. If you truly want to democratize data-driven decision-making for your end customers, you need to go one step further. And that means that dashboards are becoming a tool inside your own application from which you can drive action, you can drive changes, you can make decisions in there. And also in your platform, you could get data from these dashboards, uncover them, save them for later usage. And by doing that, you start to see the value of embedded client-facing analytics. And it will really be a growth driver for your business. Because nowadays, everybody already expects to get insights from the data that they are putting inside your platform. But by making these actionable, you instantly give them value and you go beyond what they're expecting. You give them premium value and you can adapt it to the type of user you have it. And that will bring you more loyalty, more customers, and a better solution, and thus a growth driver. I cannot stress this more. And if we look at IoT, I would say IoT is the perfect partner for embedded analytics. It generates heaps amounts of data. It's often very context specific. It allows you to slice and dice through multiple dimensions, and it allows you to offer various insights to your end customers on which they can act and make decisions on. So what are some things to think of when you're embarking on a client-facing analytics solution? I would say there's three domains. The first one is also about timing. It's about the speed of go-to-market. You ideally want it to have today and not having to wait for months or years of development time. So look for a solution that perfectly fits your own technology stack, that is open, that is composable, and it helps you grow along the way. But also look at scalability, not only, as I mentioned, scaling in numbers, but scaling in types of roles, in types of users. Some might just be okay with one number, others will need an interactive dashboard, and maybe some power users will need a sandbox inside your application where they're able to slice and dice and create their own dashboard. So try to tailor it and try to look for a solution that is able to bring you that. And then lastly, influencing speed of go-to-market is, of course, the learning curve. Do not choose for a solution where you need to send your users to a week-long training. No, look for something that is adapted to them. Because if you choose for something very hard, it will end up hurting you because you won't see any adoption, not any engagement. And that brings me to a second point, and that's engage your users. Engage them to look for insights. Engage them to find out some things that helps them get smarter and make smarter decisions, and maybe ask and let them ask for new insights and to together grow to a more smarter solution. And then lastly, very importantly, is the degree of embeddability. And what do I mean with that? Well, if you're creating a client-facing analytics solution and that that solution is external of your application, in essence, you're giving away your value. They will attribute the value that they're getting from these insights to that third-party external application. So it's really important that you have your client-facing application and analytics inside your own platform. And not only in terms of value attribution, but also in terms of being able to close the loop from insights to making decisions to gather new insights and move forward there. A question I often get is, should I build and develop my own solution or should I buy a solution? Well, to start off, you can definitely build your own solution. Today, dashboards are a commodity. So there exist many types of libraries that your developers can use to build dashboards. But beware of hidden costs, because although your developers will like to visualize some data, static dashboards are easy to create. But once you go to interactive dashboards, once you go to slicing and dicing across multiple dimensions, it becomes harder. And client-facing analytics isn't a one-stop shop. No, it evolves. Your clients evolve. Your solution evolves. External reality changes. So will your client-facing analytics. So take that into account, because you don't want to go through long development cycles for changing your dashboards, because external reality might have caught up when you release those new changes. So if you don't have the bandwidth, beware of that. Of course, you also have opportunity costs. Your developers are building dashboards. They're not focusing on your core product. And then reputation costs are important to take into account as well, because as consumers, we've grown to expect easy to use solution, especially with wearables, where we can see what happened in a very nice looking way, in a very easy to look way. So if you're offering something to your end customers, it should be easy to use and it should look well, because otherwise it might end up hurting your reputation. Of course, given that dashboards are a commodity, there's off-the-shelf solution that exists. And I think that's a good thing. Why? Because if dashboards are a commodity, then it doesn't make sense to build or develop any IP on that. Then it doesn't make sense to spend huge amounts of development time on that. Because customers are already expecting it. It takes a huge amount of time to develop it on your own, and you're not generating any IP. So why would you do that? And that's where building blocks or off-the-shelf solutions step in. They help you very quickly release client-facing applications. So with a very short speed to market, they help you get as quick as possible value on from your client-facing analytics. And then lastly, they scale very well, not only in number of users, but also in types, multi-languages, across devices, across new devices, across new ways of working. And lastly, and maybe very importantly, today development time is scarce. So they free up time because they're not spending on maintaining dashboards, on setting up servers. No, you can have them working on your core product. But of course, I'm saying this because we spent years of time to spend on creating the best of class embedded analytics solution. My name is Kyle. I'm founder and CEO of Qmal.io, and we spent around 6 years in building the best of class embedded analytics solution. Today we have more than 200 paying clients using us in 33 countries, of which huge customers, some Fortune 500 customers as well, and we're doing that with 40 people. So how do we do that? Well, very easy. We have a cloud-first platform, so you don't have to install anything. You just log in, you start creating dashboards using just drag and drop. And you can seamlessly style these dashboards to fit your own application. And once you're ready, with just a few lines of code, you can embed them in your own application. It's that easy. The dashboards are secured and multi-tenant, so person A can only see the data he or she is allowed to see, and same goes for person B. But we don't just stop there. We believe that dashboards should be tools that live inside your own application. And so we offer deeply integrated capabilities. And that means that your platform can extract data from the dashboards, can extract information from the dashboard, but also the dashboard can trigger actions in your platform. And that makes for something really powerful. I see we still have some time to go over some customer cases, which are, of course, the most interesting ones to see. So maybe one you've used already, maybe last year, maybe this year, is from Proximus, the Drukte Biometer. And here, what happened is Proximus did the heavy lifting. They used the cell phone signals. They extrapolated it against our population. And that way, people, citizens, were able to make decisions based on data, whether they should go to Sint-Idesbald or whether they should go to Ostende, depending on whether it was crowded or not at that place. And it wasn't just citizens, it was also police instances, it was also municipalities that were able to change their policies depending on data and really have data-driven decision-making live out in the open. So I think that's a nice case. Another one which is interesting to talk about is Curieuze Neuse. Not sure if you know it, but it's a citizen scientist project. Where you have 5,000 daggers across Flanders that generate information about soil quality, about temperature, about humidity. And that way we're getting insights on how climate change affects our gardens, but also on what happens with our gardens across the year. And that uncovered some amazing insights that people didn't expect up front. So one example, for example, is that people were thinking that gardens would heat up faster in cities. But in several cases, that wasn't the case. And why? Because they found out that in cities, of course, you have smaller gardens with more shade. And that made that some gardens less fast heated up compared to in rural areas. The most customer-facing cases are, of course, in the B2B or B2C world. Some interesting ones are, for example, in logistics, where we have a cold chain monitoring company using our software to show their clients information about temperature in transit, in stores, in fridge, and even on product level, in order to give certainty about food safety and food compliance. Another case is in property management, where they're gathering data from multiple sensors about energy consumption, but also energy generation, water consumption, water leakage, carbon dioxide metering, and by that giving options to their clients to optimize the use of their buildings. And you often see cases happening in sustainability. Another client is using us, for example, in data centers, where on micro level, they're getting information and they're handing out options to their end users of choosing which options they would make to decrease their carbon footprint of their data centers while keeping operational efficiency, of course. And it can be towards external customers, external clients, but it can also be internally in a company. So you have companies that have platforms that they use internally to keep everything around information of how their business is doing, around business processes, about their sales, about how customers are using them. And by giving out that information to all of their employees, everybody is able to track on how the business is doing. And you create a way that everybody works together into optimizing it. And then maybe a last case before we wrap up is Intent Technologies. This is a French player, and the reason I'm highlighting them is because they build dashboards on the fly depending on the situation of the user looking at their application at that moment in time. So what they do is they look at the user that is logged in, at their situation, and they generate dashboards using our API-first approach live. So they don't bombard their customers with heaps amounts of data, but they just show these types of information that are important to now act upon. And so I think that's really powerful. The more you make it personalized, the more you bring in valuable insights on which customers can act, the more value you will get out your client-facing analytics. And so I hope I've convinced you of the power and the value of client-facing analytics, I'm happy to take some time for questions to respond here. Three questions, okay. This is the first one. So, do I need to? What advantage would a solution like Cumul.io have over tools like Power BI, Tableau? Any cases where companies use standard BI tools together with a tool like Cumul.io for client-facing analytics? Yeah, very good question. So we're totally focused on embedded analytics, meaning analytics inside your own application. That means that there are several cases where we coexist with existing solutions for internal reporting, like Tableau, like Qlik, like Power BI. And the difference is internal reporting is creating reports for your own manager, for your own board, and it remains inside your own application. Embedded analytics and client-facing analytics is, of course, towards external users, and where it's important to be able to tailor it to their end user to make sure that you're within the security of that user, that you can handle multilingualism, multi-device. So yes, there are many cases where we coexist, and of course we don't focus on internal reporting, but really on embedded analytics. Okay. What has been the most complex obstacle to overcome? I think one important one is security. You have to create. So our solution is a solution that that is very open and very easy to connect to all parts of your technology stack. And definitely in terms of security or authentication, that's an important one, because you don't want to copy over your whole security system. You don't want to copy over your authentication rules. So the thing we worked very hard on is really to be able to work in different types of solutions, going from security and authentication, but also to generating actions in all sorts of front-end facing situations. So really the building block part is, of course, the hardest part, because you need to fit in all stacks ideally. What is the most important thing to focus on? The value that you're bringing for your end customers. And I know this is pretty vague, but a good way to start is always starting small, starting to create one dashboard where you can challenge your customers. Is this something value for you? What are you looking for? What are some questions we can answer? And so you need to look into how value can be brought to your end users. And once you have that, you need to look how they're using it, in order that you see that you drive engagement and that you drive adoption. Because adoption will make that your users, your clients will think together with you. They'll ask you more questions. And if you choose for a solution where you can easily answer these questions, then you'll make them even more loyal, and you'll grow your own solution to be able to respond to even more advanced questions. That's all? Well, I'd be happy to answer any other questions you'd have. Feel free to ping me on kyle@cumul.io. So thanks for this.
Proximus. Think possible.